To understand this a little bit more, let's take a look at a very unique scenario. Let's say we have a happy little tank trudging along through a war zone. The tank randomly fires a bullet into the air, which is actually aimed at a bunch of little enemy soldiers camping out in the environment. The tank itself has a small amount of hit points, say 3 or so. And the mortar in flight will actually destroy all of these awesome little enemy soldiers over here. The question for you then is this: which updates first in your update loop? Let's say, for instance, the infantry update first. Well, this frame, the infantry, will shoot at the tank and kill the tank, and then the bullet will update, killing the infantry. This would actually create a level playing field. An alternative scenario, however, is what if the bullet updates first? The bullet would actually kill the infantry, and they wouldn't have time to update and kill the tank. In this solution, the tank itself will actually be pretty happy, trudging along through the war zone. Now, there's not really a good pattern to attack all this. Most networked RTS games actually allow this to occur quite blindly and simply ensure that all of the clients in the simulation have the same ordering of entities. This ensures that one client doesn't update infantry, then bullet, then tank, and the other one do tank, then bullet, then infantry. I've also seen some games take a different approach to it, in a bucketized manner. So for instance, you may go ahead and bucketize and say that all of your infantry update first, and then all of your tanks, and then all of your bullets. If you ensure this grouped ordering of entities, this allows you to have the infantry get the upper hand on tanks, which gets the upper hand on those evil, evil bullets. With this layout, the infantry would update first, killing the tank, and then the bullet would update this frame, killing the infantry, leaving a level playing field for next frame.